On July 21st, Notre Dame landed finally its first basketball commitment for Mike Brey in that 2022 class. Dom Campbell, 6'8", 235-pound power forward from New Hampshire. I'm Mike Singer, and with me is Patrick Engel, Bloom and Gold men's basketball beat writer. We're going to talk all things about this commitment. Before we dive into the video, make sure you hit the thumbs up on this video if you like what you see, and please subscribe to our YouTube channel for more Notre Dame athletics coverage. So Patrick, let's just first talk about how this recruitment came together. Campbell held over 20 offers in total. How did this kind of, you know, come together for Notre Dame to win the recruitment?
Well, it really started when Campbell and his AAU team, the Middlesex Magic, went to a tournament in Dallas in May, where he had a couple of really big performances against a pair of top 60 big men in this class. And even though coaches weren't allowed to be in person at that tournament to watch, word got out, highlight clips went out. You know, these games are streamed now in a lot of cases, and that really kickstarted it. And Notre Dame was the first high major school to offer him on the heels of that weekend. And then it really took off from there to the point where by mid-June, at least one team from every Power Five conference and the Big East had offered him. And coming off of that, Campbell decided to set up some official visits pretty quickly, ended up going to Oklahoma, to Stanford, and to Notre Dame in June. He was Notre Dame's only official visitor in June. Coming into this, Notre Dame had wanted to try to get a lot of its targets on campus for officials in August when classes are back in session, or in September for some football weekends where they can really see campus at its fullest and football game day atmosphere at its best. But Campbell wanted to come early. Come on that visit early. Notre Dame made the exception there to that, had him on campus at the end of June. He initially told me he wanted to make a fall decision, put out a top list sometime this month, but he decided that he knew where he wanted to be and that it was Notre Dame. Really, that visit made a big impact on him. And, you know, he decided in July to go ahead and move up that timeline and commit to Notre Dame. And it certainly had helped that, you know, he'd been hearing good things about Notre Dame for a little while. Notre Dame was in contact with him a little bit before that offer. Mike Brey really involved in this recruitment, where his AAU team, the Middlesex Magic, producing a couple of one current Notre Dame player, Cormac Ryan, played for them for a couple of years earlier in high school. And then, of course, Pat Connaughton, NBA champion, played for the Middlesex Magic before he played for Notre Dame. Magic's coach, Michael Crotty, has a longstanding relationship with Brey, now new assistant, but also old assistant Anthony Solomon, Rob Belanis, that entire staff. So there's definitely kind of a trust factor there, I think, when Notre Dame hopped in the picture, that helped Campbell at least a little bit learn a little bit more about it early on, to the point where he wanted to come visit. And then from there, I think he really connected with Notre Dame and its staff.
Yeah, so you talked about official visits to Oklahoma and Stanford, read through some of his other offers. Davidson, got to mention Steph Curry's school, Illinois, Minnesota, of course, Oklahoma, Penn State, Providence, South Carolina, Stanford, took an official too, like you mentioned, Tennessee, Virginia Tech. Again, 24 offers per Rivals in total. So you just saw him this past weekend in Indianapolis. Tell us about this event, and we'll pop on his clips, and what you think about seeing him in person.
So I thought this was a good start to the class when Campbell committed. I think we'll see him in the Rivals 150 when it next updates later this summer. I know national analyst Jamie Shaw thinks the same. That's my conclusion as well after seeing him play. He's definitely a five, a center at the next level. I think that listing of 6'8", 235 is not exactly accurate. I probably put him closer to somewhere between 260 and 280, and wow, probably about 6'8". But he's trimmed down from being over 300 a year or two ago. But as you might expect with someone that size, post scorer who's a load to handle down there, really crafty, a right-hand favorite guy who just finds a way to get to that strong hand when he gets in the post. He's got a spin move where, actually, I think you'll see it right here a little bit in this clip, where you think of, all right, this is something that or I think it's the next one, actually.
The drop step is, yeah, a little
don't bit. Really, yeah, a spin move that you don't really think of being a, you know, a trait for a guy his size. Yeah, like you said, drop step, something he's really comfortable with there. But yeah, just finds a way to get to that good hand a real load here when they run some stuff for him, you know, coming off a screen to feed him the ball or as he rolls to the basket, are tough to stop when he gets going downhill there. Yet here you see him draw a foul and that similar thing where he catches it. They'll run a lot of things for him. You know, he can shoot, like you see here, run him off screens to get him some open three-pointers, pick and pop, you know, a little bit, even give and go. I think you saw one of those clips there where he goes to the rim and gets one. But yeah, clean motion, not a lot of wasted effort. It's not a push shot. It looks pretty smooth. That's something that he's kind of developed in these last year or so here, and that I think you really see as part of the intrigue for why he got to the status that he did pretty quickly. Is a guy who's really an inside out threat, who's a low down low but can still shoot. And then as you see in some of these later clips here, you really have to like his feel as a passer. It's not going to be a situation where you throw the ball to him in the post and the possession is just ending either with a shot or a turnover, where he can feel double teams and where that comes from and where the weakness in the defense kind of is, and find that. I mean, you'll even have one clip on here where the shot was missed, but it's a good pass to just sense where the open guy is and pass it out there. He made a three. I should go back to that. And at least once in each of the four games that I saw him play, I think I had him for an assist in each game too, or if not an assist, at least a couple of good passes that were open shots the shooter just didn't happen to make. And not the most explosive leaper, but he rebounds well enough. He plays hard in that end, just wanting to box guys out and get in position there. And the big thing when he gets to college, and even before getting to college, is to continue transforming his body. Like I said, he was at one point over 300, now down a little bit, you know, wanting to keep reshape that and adding strength. Even though you see this big guy who's a comfortable post scorer, I think you want to see him bury guys in the post a little bit more and basically sometimes have the basket scored before he even catches the ball because he's catching it so deep. I think you want to see a little bit more of that. There were times this weekend where his team kind of struggled to get him the ball in the paint a little bit, just part of that being, you know, a defensive effort to sell out, to deny him passes and front guard him because he's, you know, so big and you just don't want to let him back you down. But on defense, not someone you're going to switch with, but he held his own in pick and roll coverage. It's going to be a situation where you have him hard hedge or flat hedge and then recover. And, you know, to be able to do that in college, you want to see him be able to keep getting quicker on that end. But overall, I like this guy for Notre Dame. And I know Mike Brey and the staff have kind of seen him and compared him to playing a similar role as Bonzi Colson. I came away with kind of that same impression of just both of them are undersized bigs who can play inside out, play really hard, and are physical loads to deal with.
So you got one commitment. Who's next? What else is the staff looking to accomplish in this 2022 class? Do you have an idea of how many they're looking to take?
Yeah, on the first one, I think it's a little in flux just in terms of what the number is in the fall and in total, but it's going to be a bigger class. I would think the ideal number or number you'd like to see them get to this fall, especially if they're able to hit on a few of these other targets that I'll touch on here in a minute, is probably four. And it could be, you know, a space for five, six guys, depending on what some of these seniors do with that extra COVID year, or guys who had eligibility anyway, but might want to, you know, if they decide to go somewhere else and grad transfer, or in a situation where, yeah, you have the fifth year after playing 4 years and you just want to go be a pro. We'll see there. And that five to six, that could be some high school guys, some transfer portal guys, which of course wouldn't really happen on the portal end until next spring. But yeah, some names to know as we go through the rest of the target list here, guys, they've been on for a while and some newer offers. Got to start with JJ Starling, four-star guard out of La Lumiere from upstate New York. He's a top 50 guy who rose into that top 50 earlier this year. Big time target for Notre Dame. He was on campus twice in June for unofficial visits. He got to spend a lot of time around the team. Next thing there is going to be trying to get him back for an unofficial visit, as the school year gets going. Rodney Rice out of Dematha in suburban DC, another longtime guard target Notre Dame has been in touch with for over a year. He's planning to try to get to an official at Notre Dame this fall. Notre Dame made his top six earlier this year. Another top 60 guy who's, you know, risen into that with a strong junior year. And then going a little bit more on the wing here, or actually I should first mention Desmond Claude, newer offer, lead guard, combo guard, who's really blown up this summer into a high major prospect. Jameel Brown, a guard out of Philly, four-star prospect and a former Purdue commit. His team won the Peach Jam with team final there on the Nike UIBL circuit. Didn't have the best week there. Plays on a really deep and good team like you might expect for a Peach Jam winner. Sometimes can get a little crowded out there. And then going on the wing, Alex Caravan, a top 150 player, plays at IMG from the Northeast. Newer offer, someone who I think has some interest and, you know, I'm looking at as a guy who might come on campus for an official. Big wing, kind of fits in the mold of a sort of a Nate Leshefsky type guy, really good shooter, someone who I think Notre Dame's going to really go after here pretty hard as, you know, now you start getting into more official visit season. Isaac Trout, who I also saw in Indianapolis this weekend, top 70 player out of Nebraska, plays on the Under Armour circuit. Notre Dame's going to try to get in there with him. He took a few visits in June, still hasn't committed yet. Notre Dame kind of, you know, we'll see if it's can make a move here now that he is leaving the door open for someone else to come in after not ending up still being uncommitted after taking some visits at Michigan State, North Carolina, Virginia, among his destinations in June. And then Cam Whitmore, another wing from the D.C. area, Archbishop Spalding High School in Maryland. I'm told Notre Dame absolutely loves him. His uncle Bob Whitmore played at Notre Dame in the 60s. Real explosive athlete here who could play on the wing, shoot, jump out of the gym. Really intriguing prospect here for Notre Dame. So those are some of the names to watch. Who you're going to see how many of them Notre Dame can actually get on campus for official visits and see if they can make a move there when they, if they do come on campus.
Well, that's going to do it for this video. Appreciate you guys sticking around and learning more about Notre Dame men's basketball recruiting in this 2022 class. Again, if you like what you saw in this video, please hit the thumbs up. Go to blueandgold.com for all of your Notre Dame basketball coverage and all things Fighting Irish athletics.